Wait, is the mic is working. The mic's definitely working, guys. Okay, here we go. Back to the Brood War music, rather than the Home Alone music, because I don't want the games to be muted. And here we go, we have spawning in the 9 o'clock position as the Green Zerg. It is Richly Zara. If there's a little bit of lag, hopefully they switch it to high latency or something, and if that doesn't work, we'll re-host. If they do want to play on turn rate 16, then we can always cast from replays, that's fine. And in the bottom right, we do have the Brown Zerg. Soul Miso. Okay, but here we go. Let's just quickly update this. Looks like they're just trying extra high, just to see if that's okay. And if it's not, I will back out and I'll let them play and I'll cast from replays. I really don't mind that. I want the best experience for the players. Because I think that leads to better games overall when there's no lag, so you know what? Let's just set the colors quickly. It is green versus brown, and I'm probably missing the most important part of ZBZ, but here we go. So we don't see anything crazy. Possible 9 pool coming up here for Miso, although Miso is going to be doing a gas trick. So likely going into an extra drone first, trying to sneak out the extra drone. Extra thing you can. And yeah, John Williams did the Home Alone soundtrack. That's why it's so good. Yeah, we see the gas trick coming up for me, so maybe this isn't a gas trick. Maybe he's just going for a super early gas. Yeah, he is. He's going gas before pool. Interesting. I've not seen that before. At least I probably have and not noticed. But gas before pool here for Miso. And Richly. Richly's going for a 12 hatch. So this could be a very quick game. And that could be a problem. Not a problem for us necessarily, but definitely a problem for Richly here, because this is a very greedy build to do in ZBZ in the first game of a series. Miso is known for being pretty aggressive in the ZBZ, so it'll be interesting to see how well this works out. Now, one joke I was making before I didn't realize I was muted, basically, the reason why ZBZ is going to work out so well for both these players is so far their TBZs have both gone 2 hatch meter a couple of times. Now, they've shown they're good at 2 hatch meter, and you know what ZBZ usually is? I mean, it's usually 2 hatch meter, realistically. Sometimes you get 1 hatch meter, sometimes you get, like, a Ling All In or something, but the majority of the time you will have 2 hatch meter, so using their skills they've picked up in TBZ, in their ZBZ as well. And you know what? Let's see what we can do. And to the person asking if they're accepting extra high lat, it's extra high lat on turn rate 16 is basically low latency on turn rate 14, from what I understand. No, maybe a little bit better than that, actually. Either way, we see. Is either player going to get overlorded? Yeah, it looks like Miso is overlorded, and he is going for 2 hatcheries in his main. It looks like we do have the first Ling out on the map, going to try and do what he can, but Richly getting his Lings out at the perfect time to defend this. And Miso is unfortunately unable to really make anything with this 2 hatcheries. I can only imagine that this early gas is going to be for an earlier Spire. And yes, it is, 2 hatch Spire in his main base. No expansion from Miso will be coming up anytime soon. And you know what, this could actually be quite dangerous for Miso here. He doesn't have that many Lings given the fact he has 2 hatcheries, and he won't have the same economy as Richly does. He's not going to be able to put any pressure on. Wow, nice pullback there by Richly, pulling the Ling back that was targeted to try and deal with that weird movement you can do where you like break through one of the Lings. But nice defense by Miso as Richly does try and break through here, but it's not going to be enough. Now, where is the lair? The lair is not finished yet. four ritually here. The second base is done. There's no drones mining there. But this defense is just too strong for Misa. But he needs to be careful though. There's a lot of blinks coming down. The Spire is nearly finished, about two-thirds of the way through. Sunken Colony is up as well to try and defend. And using this this hatchery to try and help Wall. Gonna make it a little bit harder to drone drill around the Spire there. So not really too sure what he's gonna do here, but here we go. Ling's moving in from the top. Speed is done for Richly. Speed is not done for Misa yet. Yes it is actually. So speed versus speed. Quicker Spire, of course, does go to Miso. So when he does get his Spire up, when he can start building those Mulas, he may be able to do something, but he needs to survive. He needs to hold on against this constant Ling pressure coming in. And here we go. Thank you, Dreamcatter, for pointing out there's still $3 more to give. I'm not sure how many codes there are left, but thank you. And here we go. The Lings are moving in. They do get one drone. Not really worth that trade, but here we go. The Overlord is completely vulnerable here. I don't know why he left it here for so long. But it does delay the Meatless from going into his base. Now, is the Spire done for him? No, it looks like he is actually going to go in for an Evo Chamber. The Evo Chamber has finished. He's going to be adding on two Spores at each base, but this is going to be so much damage by Miso and so much damage for Richly to take. He's down 10 supply, where he has built so many Lings. How many drones is Miso on? So Miso is actually on 9 drones. Richly is only on 7. Richly does have the drone advantage, but it means he's lost all of his army units. And this is not going to be good. And Miso just showing his prowess in TBT. He's going to push in with his Mutelist. How much damage can he do? Probably not that much. There is two Spores. He needs to be careful. Losing a Mutelist there for only one drone. Not the best choice to make when he is... he is actually behind on the drone count. He can't be losing these Mutelists like this. But here we go. The Mutelist still moving around. No Spy yet, of course. For Richly, he is foregoing the Spy to just try and drone up with the Spore colonies. But what is he going to do about this Ling counterattack? There's so many Lings coming out on the map. There's just so many Lings. So many lava have gone into Lings here. And this is going to do so much damage. Luckily, fortunately, he does scout this. They're playing on the camouflage colors for the map. I've just realized. Green and brown. Here we go. He's trying to build a sunken bit. Is it going to be enough? There's just so many Lings here. I don't know what Richly's going to be able to do. And when these Spores go down, the Mutas are going to come in and clean house. But I don't even think he needs them. So many Lings doing so much damage. And I think Miso is just going to end this game here. Right here and now. GG is called. And Miso goes 1-0 up in this best of three grand final for the Clash for Christmas. Okay, here we go. Let's update the overlay and let's host up Hitchhiker, which will be our second map here of the day, of the final even. Hello, AA11, let's try... Yeah, just finding out from the players what they want to try. In regards to lag and stuff. So let's do turn rate 14. Hopefully they can do turn rate 14 on low. There wasn't too much lag, but I guess they were on extra high. Does it though? Okay. Here's Hitchhiker, guys. If you haven't seen it, there are in different places there are power generators that we've seen before. There's power generators here. Power generators blocking these. There are actually side disruptors here. Temples here. Power generators here. And side disruptors again. Looks like they're both ready. I'm ready. You guys should hopefully be ready as well. Let's check. They're both ready. GG, GL, HF, GGO. And let's go. And here we go, spawning in at the top left position. We do have the purple Zerg. It is Richly RRF who needs to win the next two games to win the grand final of the Clash for Christmas. The first and hopefully not the last Clash for Christmas. It looks like turn rate 14 hasn't actually helped very much, but there we go. Miso has set the latency too high for now. And spawning over here on the right-hand side, we do have the Orange Zerg. Up 1-0 in the finals, needs one more game to win the tournament and the majority share of the prize pool. It is my teammate, the ex-CJ Pro Gamer, I think it was CJ, Miso, or Souls Miso. And let's just quickly add that into the overlay and set the colours. This is of course a map we've seen countless times today, so I actually quite like this map. I'll probably bring this map back for the next Clash Royale, maybe. Not entirely sure, but I guess we'll see what the viewing public do want. Probably going to have a Clash Royale in maybe 2 weeks. I think next week I'm going to chill out a bit. It is going to be New Year's Eve. I won't have too much to do on New Year's Eve, but I'll be gaming at home, just doing the cool stuff. May even stream me losing a Brood War for a bit. But here we go. We do have, looks like 9 pool for both players. It looks like we're going to have quicker gas this time for Rich Lee. He's going to go for 9 pool, 8 gas. Whereas Miso did actually get that extra drone out, so he went 9 pool, 9 gas into another drone. So back at 9 supply. But that does delay his overload, as we can see. And yeah, I'll check the match reader in a moment when I focus on the game. This could very well be the last game of today. We'll soon find out. But a huge thanks to everyone who has donated so far, everyone who used the code, and everyone who donated normally. It does mean a lot. Thanks once again to Matarino for giving me the codes to begin with. And hopefully this will be far from the last of Clash of Chars. I'll definitely be hosting more of these in the new year. I think Miso was, back in the day, a B-teamer. But he still played on Pro League, I'm fairly certain. He got to the round of 4 or the round of 8 in one of the MSLs, if I remember correctly. I'm not entirely sure. I need to check that. Someone fact check that for me in chat. That would be great. Yeah, Rich Lee's doing a really, really good job here, but is he going to be able to hold? Looks like Miso's going to be a little bit more aggressive this time with his lings, trying to break up the ramp again. It'll be a little bit hard to get up this ramp, though. Richly actually throwing away some lings, trying to get down the ramp. Not the best choice there, but he is going to try and break out. He doesn't want to get stuck on his one base. He wants to expand by the looks of it, but I'm not sure he's going to be able to expand there. Now, what's going on in Miso's base? He's going for that one hatchery lair again. Oh, he was going 2 hatch lair last time, so that's a lie. And we see the same from Richly here. Miso with the gas advantage, though. Look at that. 100 gas advantage there. Looks like they both just add their lairs on. So I will just confirm that. They added the spires. They already had the lairs on the way. But Miso will have the gas advantage moving forward. He did get the quicker gas. Oh, my bad. He was in the PD Pop MSL round of 36 and back at OSL 2010 round of 36. There we go. That's cool. But Miso has, I really appreciate everyone who plays in my tournaments. Miso, of course, my teammate now, so extra appreciation for him. Same goes to Scan and anyone else who did participate today. If it wasn't for you guys playing, I wouldn't be casting these, wouldn't be having a blast on December 23rd. Casting a Christmas special, which is kind of insane to me, but there we go. Even if there was no viewers, I would cast, because I have a lot of fun. Apparently, 0 brings up the win-loss ratio of the players. Hopefully, this doesn't desync me from the game. That's happened before. Yeah, if it wasn't for the players playing in the tournament, there wouldn't be any tournaments to begin with. So, thanks once again. Of course, there was like the Holiday Bash recently. It's really good we have events like that, because it does drive up interest in Brood War in general. But I hope to continue to make tournaments that people can participate in of any skill level and just have a bit of fun, really, and win some money at the end of it. Because, you know what? That's what I set out to do. I want people to have fun. That's why I make people play different maps. Like, people calling for... That's why I saw people calling for Christmas Clash Royale or whatever. Sorry. Or Christmas Fighting Spirit. But realistically, we've already seen Fighting Spirit so much. I don't want to see a snow version of it in the tournament. There's no point. I'd rather see a map like Hitchhiker that barely ever sees play anymore, just because it is so fun. It's such an interesting map design. Don't really see anything like it. Looks like we do have the first Mewless out for both players. Miso, of course, with the quicker second hatchery. It looks like we see an inverse of the previous game. Ridgely is going to have to build a second hatchery in his main. He couldn't get down his ramp quick enough. And here we go. It looks like we do see the Mewless microing back and forth. We do see the first Scourge, though, coming out for Miso instead. Looks like he is going to go for Scourge quicker than Ridgely will. It's kind of interesting how you see like two different styles of CVC. You see, we saw it in the ASL recently where Effort went for like mass Scourge early on, just to try and take down as many Mutalisks as he could before he switched into his own Mutalisks. And that does work really well. I mean, even mixing in like one or two Scourge, like Miso has as well, really good. You could even use them to take out Overlords if you really want to. And my observing has been a bit funky today, but hopefully it's all been good. Yeah, it looks like we just see both players just kind of building up their Mutalisk count. We do, as we see here, look at how many Scourge are on the way. Looks like Ling's just poking in, trying to do any damage they can. Not going to really be able to do too much, but here we go. The first major battle, Scourge on Scourge. Nice micro from Miso. Nice micro from both players, actually. Such a huge battle going down, but so many, oh man, so many connections with Scourge from both sides, actually, that was a lot closer than I thought it was going to be there. Only four Mewless versus three. Three versus three now. Wow, this is so close. This could go either way. It's a knife edge right now. Nice micro from both players, but it looks like Ridgely will get the benefit of the added end to that engagement. And here we go, more Scourge are on the way. Two Mewless is not enough to micro that down, so he's gonna have to pull back. It looks like he's gonna send his own Scourge in, trying to snipe any Overlord or any Mewless trying to come on the edge. But nice Scourge connection there by Miso, does take out both of the Scourge. And here we go, trying to use his micro tricks to try and take down these Scourge to defend his base, but I think he manages to do that. I don't know if he ate that Scourge there. It doesn't look like he did. But he does eat that one. Another Mutalisk does go down. Another two lanes coming in, trying to do some damage. Not going to be really enough. No expansion yet for Ridgely. Ridgely is the one who's behind right now on the drone count, on the hatcheries. Ultra, if you put the coupon code in on its own, you can just donate that. That's fine. It's just $1. $3, but here we go. Another Scourge does connect. Looks like Ridgely, though, has added a lot of links here rather than going for extra Mutalisks, so this could be quite dangerous. There isn't that much ground defense, but there is four Mutalisks. Now, maybe he's doing this in reaction to the fact there has been so many Scourge coming out from Miso. But these links aren't really going to be able to do too much. They're going to try and run in. They're going to get stuck on the cliff. The like Zerglings all go down. Looks like he's going to try and take out some drones, but two Mutalisks are not enough to even micro down a single drone and a single... I think that was two volleys as well. And Miso is just in a commanding position in this game now. It looks like more and more Lings have been produced. Only an extra couple of Mutalisks are on the way. Four Mutalisks should be enough to micro down a drone or two. But this is going to be a best of three, guys. This is like a sort of a special tournament. I don't want to keep people too long on Christmas Eve Eve. I know for Miso and Ridgely right now, it's actually Christmas Eve. Very early in the morning. I don't want to keep them up too late. So I did make it best of three the whole way through this week. But here we go. Looks like we will have the Mewless coming in. Looks like Ling's just suiciding in, really, not doing too much damage. And I think, like, Ridgely is trying to do what he can with the Mewless he has, but he's down in Mewless count. The Scourge are going to move in now as well, and I think this is going to be the end of the game for Ridgely. I'm not sure he's going to be able to come back from this. Two Mewless do survive, but Ridgely GG's, and Miso will be the Clash for Christmas Special Edition Grand Champion, and he will take home 50% of the prize pool, which as of now does sit at, let's just double check, see how many coupon codes have been used. I see a lot of people have been using them, $144, so if you want to use the coupon code, now is the time to add to it. I'll be giving out the prize pool very shortly. I think all the players are actually in the right place, but do !! Matcherino, and put in the code in the blue box of the stream. And I mean, there's not much to say. Miso does win that. Let's just update the overlay. Or did Richley win game one? I can't remember. No, Misa won game one, yeah. So congratulations to him. Let's just bring it back to my camera just to do my little closing blurb. Of course, as you all know, it is Christmas in a day and a half or a day or 2 days, wherever you are. I hope you all have a wonderful Christmas. I'll probably be streaming in between sort of just random games and stuff, but I won't be casting. So have a good Christmas, a good new year, and hopefully this has been a good end to the tournaments in 2017. I know there's probably a couple of more coming. There probably won't be a TL Open until next year again. So here's hoping to a strong 2018 to foreign Brood War tournaments, and hopefully for Brood War in general. Just keep supporting all the streamers you can, keep watching everyone. Keep watching the Korean pros, keep them playing as well, because the game wouldn't really exist without them. So once again, thank you all very much for tuning in. Thank you everyone for playing. And I will see you guys in the new year. So thank you very much. Bye.